First example is find the area bounded by x minus 1 square plus y square equal to 1 and x square plus y square equal to 1. So this is circle with center 1 comma 0 and radius 1. So this is the circle with center 1 comma 0 and radius 1. So this circle x minus 1 whole square plus y square equal to 1, and another circle is x square plus y square equal to 1 unit circle, that is circle with center 0 comma 0 and radius 1, radius is 1. So when we solve equation 1 and 2, we get coordinates of point of intersection as P 1/2 comma root 3 by 2 and Q 1/2 comma minus root 3 by 2. It is easy to solve this equation because from equation 1, y square equal to 1 minus x minus 1 whole square. From second equation, y square equal to 1 minus x square. Comparing both y square, 1 minus x minus 1 whole square equal to 1 minus x square. We can cancel 1 both sides. Again solving this, x minus 1 square equal to x square. So x minus 1 equal to plus minus x when we take square root. So from this, x minus 1 equal to x, or x minus 1 equal to minus x. This is not possible because we get 1 equal to 0. So from this, 2x equal to 1, so x equal to 1/2. So x equal to 1/2, using x equal to 1/2 from unit circle for point of intersection, y square equal to 1 minus x square. So 1 minus 1 by 4, so 3 by 4, and therefore y equal to plus minus root 3 by 2. So we have obtained coordinates of point of intersection as P 1/2 comma root 3 by 2 and Q 1/2 comma minus root 3 by 2. So as shown in the figure, that shaded region, we have to find area of this portion if we consider alpha. Now two curves intersect each other into x equal to g1y, so this is x equal to g1y, and x as a function of y from the unit circle, and x equal to g2y, that is x as a function of y from second curve, it is this one, which is portion of x minus 1 whole square plus y square equal to 1. So required area according to this formula, I c2d g1y minus g2y dy. So x as a function of g1y, so x equal to g1y from this curve, that is unit circle, from the equation of circle x square plus y square equal to 1, so y square equal to 1 minus x square, and in the first quadrant y is positive, so y equal to under root 1 minus, sorry, x square equal to 1 minus y square, x equal to plus minus under root 1 minus y square, and required portion lies in the first and fourth quadrant in which x is positive. So x as a function of y, we have taken x equal to under root 1 minus y square. X as a function of y, g1y. Now g2y, when we take x equal to g2y, x as a function of y, now we have to take special care, x as a function of y, this portion. Now this portion, it comes from the circle, which circle? X minus 1 whole square plus y square equal to 1. So x minus 1 square, 1 minus y square, therefore x minus 1 equal to plus minus under root 1 minus y square. So x equal to 1 plus minus under root 1 minus y square. Now you take care, x equal to 1, this is the vertical line. This is the vertical line, x equal to 1. X equal to 1. So if we take 1 plus something, suppose we take 1 plus under root 1 minus y square, that means we are using this portion of the circle. So which we not want to use, so we have to consider this portion, x as a function of y, x as a function of y. So this is vertical line, x equal to 1, x equal to 1. So if we take 1 minus, x equal to 1 minus under root 1 minus y square, then we can use this portion of the circle. So take care, we cannot take 1 plus under root 1 minus y square. X equal to 1, this is vertical line, 1 plus something, that is this portion, but we are interested in this portion. So we have taken x equal to 1 minus under root 1 minus y square. Now it is regular definite integral. So simplify this one. Now use property in minus a to a, if function is even, then value is 2 times 0 to a. So this is 2 times under root 2 into under root 1 minus y square minus 1, and limit minus a to a becomes 2 times 0 to a. So 2 times 0 to root 3 by 2. Now here use formula under root a square minus x square. So x by 2 into under root a square minus x square. So here according to formula, integration is y by 2 under root 1 minus y square plus a square by 2, that is 1 half, sin inverse y by 1, limit 0 to root 3 by 2, and integration of 1, that is y. So y, limit 0 to root 3 by 2. So first put upper limit here minus lower limit. So here when we put upper limit, y equal to root 3 by 2, root 3 by 4 into 1 half plus 1 half sin inverse y root 3 by 2. In the case of lower limit, y 0, so this term is 0, sin inverse 0 is 0, so this term is 0. Here integration 1 dy, that is y, put upper limit root 3 by 2. In the case of lower limit, it will be 0. This is simplification. So final simplification is root 3 by 4 minus root 3 by 2. So we have taken simplification will be minus root 3 by 2, sin inverse root 3 by 2, it will be pi by 3. So outside in the multiplication we have 2, so final answer is 2 pi by 3 minus root 3 by 2 square unit. Next example, find the area of the region bounded by the curves y equal to x square plus 2, y equal to x square plus 2, that is parabola and y equal to x, that is line passing through origin making 45 degree with positive direction of x axis and vertical line x equal to 3. So this is the line x equal to 3. So this is the line y equal to x, this is x axis, this is y axis, this is parabola y equal to x square plus 2, x square is positive, 2 is positive, so x square plus 2 is positive, that means parabola lies in the first and second quadrant because in first and second quadrant y is positive. This is the line x equal to 3. So now y equal to x square plus 2, only even power of x, so parabola, it is symmetric about y axis because equation contains only even power of x. Now parabola y equal to x square plus 2, so this is y equal to x square plus 2 parabola. Y equal to x, y equal to x, that is line passing through origin making 45 degree with positive direction of x axis, because if we compare it with y equal to mx, slope is 1, so tan theta is 1. Tan theta is 1, that means line makes an angle pi by 4 with positive direction of x axis. Next, so parabola line y equal to x, x equal to 0, x equal to 0, that is y axis, so this is y axis, and finally x equal to 3, that is vertical line. So area bounded by these four curves is, this is the required area. We have to find area of this portion. So required area, now which formula we will use? If y equal to f of x, required area, equal to integration a to b f1x minus f2x dx. As a to b, limit here 0, 0, here 3, 0, so as a to b, limit will be 0 to 3. f1x, y as a function of x, so from the parabola y as a function of x, so x square plus 2, x square plus 2. So using this we will get entire area. And minus, when we subtract y equal to f of x, y equal to f of x, y as a function of x from straight line. So this is x dx, that means we are subtracting this portion and remaining will be area between four curves y equal to x square plus 2 y equal to x y x equal to 0 x equal to 0, that is y axis. So f1x, y is a function of x, this is f1x, that is from the parabola. So we have taken x square plus 2 minus f2x, y is a function of x, so minus x dx. Now this is regular definite integration 0 to 3 x square plus 2 minus x dx. You can integrate term wise. So by first integral we are getting entire area, and when we subtract y equal to x, we are subtracting this portion because of y equal to x. This portion we are subtracting, so remaining area will be area of intersection of all the four curves. Now this is x square integration x cube by 3 plus 2x minus x square by 2 limit 0 to 3. First put upper limit, minus we will put lower limit. So when we put upper limit, 3 cube 27 by 3, so this is 9 plus 3 2s are 6 minus 9 by 2. And in the case of lower limit, x is 0, so this is 15 minus 9 by 2, so this is 30. 15 into 2, 30 minus 9, so that will be 21 by 2 square unit. We take one more example. Find the area using integration find the area of the triangular region whose sides have the equation y equal to 2x plus 1, y equal to 3x plus 1 and x equal to 4. So let us discuss solution. Area, we have to get area triangular region, area of the triangular region whose sides having the equation y equal to 2x plus 1, y equal to 3x plus 1, y equal to 2x plus 1 and y equal to 3x plus 1. So when we solve this equation, coordinates of point of intersection comparing both y, so x will be 0. If we put x 0, y will be 1. So 0 comma 1 is the point of intersection for these two lines. Now y equal to 2x plus 1, x equal to 4. Now let us find coordinates of point of intersection of line y equal to 2x plus 1 and x equal to 4. Put x equal to 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 plus 1 9. So here for these two line, coordinates of point of intersection is if we take x equal to 4, y is 9, so 4 comma 9 is point of intersection of line y equal to 2x plus 1 and y equal to 3x plus 1. Similarly, let us find coordinates of point of intersection with y equal to 3x plus 1 and x equal to 4. So if you put x equal to 4, 4 3s are 12 plus 1, that is 13. So if this is P 4 comma 9, then this will be Q 4 comma 13. So now we are able to draw the triangular region. Both line intersect each other into point 0 comma 1, 0 comma 1. So this is y-axis. X-axis. So x-axis, y-axis, we call this is 0 comma 1. This is the line x equal to 4, here this is the point P, this is the point Q, P 4 comma 9, Q, sorry, this is 4 comma 4 comma 13, you can observe Q q4 comma 13 y coordinate is greater than, so this is q4 comma 13, this is p4 comma 9, so this is line y equal to 2x plus 1, because if we take x equal to 4, 4 2s are 8 plus 1, y will be 9, and this is the line y equal to 3x plus 1. So in y equal to 3x plus 1, if we take x equal to 4, 4 into 3, 12 plus 1, so q will be 4 comma 13. So now we have to get area of this portion, this triangle. So required area A equal to mod I A to B F1X minus F2X DX using this formula, integration I A to B, limit will be here 0 to 4, here x equal to 0, that is y axis, this is x equal to 4, so 0 to 4. F1x, y as a function of x from upper line, this is the line y equal to 3x plus 1, so 3x plus 1 minus y equal to f2x, y equal to f2x, so y equal to f2x, so 2x plus 1, 2x plus 1 dx. Actually by first integral we are getting entire region, and when we subtract second, when we subtract 2x plus 1, that means we are removing from entire region, we are removing this portion, so remaining portion will be the area of required triangle, this area of required triangle. So from f1x we are getting entire area, by f2x we are removing this portion, from y equal to f1x we are getting entire area, and when we subtract second integral we are removing this portion, so remaining will be the area of the required triangle. Now this is ordinary definite integral, term wise you can integrate this thing. So this is 3x square by 2 plus x, or we can simplify 3x, first we simplify this thing, 0 to 4, 3x minus 2x, x dx, plus 1 minus 1 cancel, this is x square by 2, 0 to 4, put upper limit, x equal to 4, 16 by 2 minus lower limit, so simplification is 8 square unit, this is the required area, 8 square unit. So only we have used theory, this is f1x, this is f2x, x equal to a, x equal to b, we have used this formula a to b f upon x minus f to x dx. So by first integral we are getting entire area, and when we subtract this one we can remove this portion. So remaining is the area of the required triangle, which is, as we have obtained the calculation, and it is 8 square unit. This is the required area.